this final video, we're going to show the value of CVA, or at least we put it all together and we can see even more value of CVA. If you are confused what I'm talking about, if you don't even know what CVA is, you should probably watch the first three videos in this group of videos. So I pretty much have re-implemented all the buttons that we had below, but now I want to add a different color to them. I want them to be a little bit different. Another thing I also want is when I click on these, I don't actually really see anything happen visually. I would like it to maybe just change colors a little bit would be kind of nice. So I'm going to add that too. So here we can see pretty much what we're changing is we're changing the intent. So instead of BG Indigo, we could do like BG Teal. And all of a sudden, everything is updated, which is super cool. I don't like teal 600, it's a little too light, so we're gonna do teal 700. That looks nice. And the text white, that's great. Of course, the hover is gonna need to be different. That doesn't look right, so we'll do teal. And if we go to teal, okay, it's a little light for me. So I'm gonna go darker. And now we can see that looks pretty good. And let's see, was there anything else? Okay, that visible. So yeah, if I'm tabbing through for the keyboard, that should definitely match. That should be teal 600. We'll see what that is. It looks pretty good. We should probably make it actually match though. So there we go. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, so the secondary looks good. Let's just go on to the soft version. So we don't want that to be indigo. We want that to be teal again. So teal 600, let's change that again to 700. That looks good. The hover, of course, should be teal as well. So if we hover, it looks pretty decent. And then let's talk about that active state that I was talking about. When I click, I want this to change. So we're going to say active for the primary one. We'll say BG teal, and then I want it to get a little darker. So if I change that, then now for all of these, whenever I click, it actually gets slightly darker, which is cool. Here, I'm going to make the active BG gray, and I'll just go up to 100. Should be good. So hover, and then, yep, slightly darker. And then finally with this one, it should be active BG teal. Let's do 200. And yep, that looks all right. Maybe you want to tweak that one a little bit. It's not totally my favorite, but it works. Cool. So that's really the power of CVA. That's one aspect of it I really like. Again, I could have built some system around this that worked for me and kind of hobbled everything together and used ternaries and all sorts of stuff. But this to me is just, it's already a nice API that works really well. And it gives me all the type safety, which is great. And it's actively being developed and maintained. They are working on version 1, and it'll probably be out by the time you're watching this video. So yeah, definitely check that out and see what other niceties they've added. But overall, I find this as a really easy way to make a nice component with having that be your inner kind of guts of how everything works. And then the component, as you're building it out, all you have to pass in is props like intent and size and rounded. And like I said, you can even pass in a class name and add more class names if you need to add extra styles. So thanks for watching, and I hope this was really helpful and interesting. If you have ideas for other videos or other libraries you'd like me to explore, feel free to leave a comment and let me know. Thanks.